If you were a Burgess, you know, my grandmother, my meemaw would take you down to the river. First of all, she'd throw you off the pier, teach you how to swim.
Sure.
And then you got out there and you learned to ski. I mean, there was no way around it. So we all grew up learning to ski. Well, it dawned on me that my children have never been exposed because, unfortunately, my grandparents, you know, we lost my granddad and my grandmother got where they had, you know, their age-wise, could not keep up the place down on the river, and the rest of us didn't live here at that time. So we don't have it anymore. And I thought, my kids have never water skied. They've never even been taught to water ski. So on vacation, Sherry's family lives at Lake Gunnersville. I said, one of the things we will do is take the kids up there, and I'm going to work with them and teach them how to ski.
They own a boat?
Yeah, her brother's got a boat.
I didn't know they had money.
Well, you know, I married into money.
There you go.
But the only thing is, our system was, we had a place on the Black Warrior River, we had a pier, and everybody swam, and it was shallow enough you could touch the bottom, and you swam and all this, and the boat would come around, and it was your turn to ski. You'd swim out there, put your skis on, somebody be in the water with you, somebody in the boat, you'd learn how to ski. Well, this system, they didn't have that. It was everybody in the boat. We go out to, you know, 100 feet of water, and everybody who skis jumps in and out of the boat.
Right.
And everybody's in the boat. So I am starting to think, now, how am I going to teach the kids to ski? And they've never done it before. And I'm going to tell you, my kids were shocked at how hard it is. Because, you know, their whole life, somebody said, get on the jet ski. You know, and you get out there and you wide up. Man, get on the jet ski. Let me drop. You know, and all that. So, you know, you first of all.
How did it go, Rick?
So you get in the water. You know, you got to get your skis pointed up. You got to get the rope in between them.
It used to be a ski belt.
And you're treading water. So I think to myself, you know, keep in mind, the last time I skied was 12 to 14 years ago. But as you know, with my roller skating,
you figured you could still.
Riding a bike.
I feel like I still got it. So I'm looking around the boat, and Sherry's there, and Sherry has never seen me ski. So I can't wait to show Sherry how well I can ski.
Oh yeah.
But I'm having to be impatient because, you know, the kids are trying to learn and they can't do it. And I realize at one point, if I'm gonna teach them to ski, it's gonna be an all day event. This is not the time. This is not the place. So I get them out of the water.
Right.
So I'd gotten out there, and I said, so I just grab a life jacket. Now, the last time I skied, I probably weighed 225 pounds, right. 220,
right.
Maybe even 215. So I now weigh 280. So I said, hand me one of these.
Did the poor boat have a chance?
What?
Did you take it under?
I said, let me have that life jacket. So I just grab one. Now, as I'm putting it on, I realize it's more of a fishing jacket instead of a ski jacket. It's not an official ski jacket, but I think it's good enough. And it's good because I'm a fine swimmer. And I put it on and like that, and the skis are out there floating like that. And I said, poof, and I go in the water, and I dive in, and whoo, and I come up. And I said, all right, here we go. And I said, this is going to be a great moment because my kids are going to see their dad ski. I'm going to be jumping waves. I'm going to be slapping the skis on the water. You know what I mean? And I mean, it's going to get Sherry wound up that we may even have to get a room. You know what I mean? You know, because we got the grandparents here. They can keep the kids, you know. And so I get out there in the water. So I'm out there in the water, and I go to put my ski on in the water while treading. And all of a sudden, just a little moment of water gets up. And I kind of spit the water out. And I go.
That is one of the worst feelings.
Yeah. And I said, this life jacket is not holding me like it really needs to. You know what I mean? So all of a sudden, I go get the and I'm sinking. And I go, look, then there's that first just slight panic tread, that first where you hit your hands one time to kind of hold you up. Look, and so you know, and you're not wanting to panic. You know what I mean? You go, and the kids are all watching, daddy, daddy. I love y'all. You know, and about that time, look, it goes, and it jumps up on the side of my face, the life jacket, and it starts attempting to dunk me. You know what I mean? Where it gets up on you,
it doesn't want,
and it's putting you down. Yeah. You know what I mean? Love you, daddy. Like that, and Sherry go, here we go. And so I go, and I give him the signal to go.
Good idea.
Yeah, I got to get out of this water. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All I can see is like your wrist.
But you know, and the signal, seriously, Sherry said it appeared that there was a signal given from a headless skier. You know what I mean? Because it's up over my head. You know, like that. Yeah, take it. And so the boat gives out this horrific. Now, keep in mind, Sherry's brother, my brother-in-law, is so excited because he's got this boat. He's worked on it. He's fixed it. He's got it running like a top.
Okay?
Kind
of motor? Yeah. What, how big is the
motor? I don't know all that. It's an inboard motor. Yeah. It was very impressive. It ran very smooth. So, well, it did. So I get back there, and it goes like that. And look, and I mean, even the kids' faces, they said, went. Everybody knew the boat wasn't going to make it.
Well, when it goes
when
down.
When that boat pulled tight. Yeah.
when the back end takes water.
Well, you know, as a big guy, a lot of times we got to stay in the water longer to come out of the hole is what we called it. Yeah. We used to call it coming out of the hole.
Right.
So, and I'm now being drugged like I am chum in the water. You know what I mean?
The boat can't get up to speed.
And the boat can't do it. People say they don't know what it was. Something shot out from the boat into the water. Yeah. Some kind of mess just.
I think it was the ground up interior of the engine.
Listen, an alarm goes off inside the boat. And I'm still in the water. So there comes a moment where I go, I need to just let go or I'm going to drown. You know, when you that little moment, you go, going to drown. You know, like that. So I get almost up, and my skis are still in the. Now, my athletic ability is at least getting me. People say I was technically up at one point. Yeah. It didn't last very long.
You were out of the hole, but you wasn't up.
Not completely out. So I let go in the boat, you know, and it's coming back around. Now the wake of the boat. And my skis have come up.
A mild taste of gasoline.
Yeah, yeah, and I've got just a little. Look, there's gasoline and a hit of oil because yep. Something's happened. It has shot gook out into the water from trying to pull me up. And then I say, look, you know how you have to make the call? I'm out there, and they said, let's try it again. Like that, and I reached to get my ski, and I'm gone. I realize I can't breathe. And all of a sudden, I grabbed my skis, seriously, throw them in the water, I said, that's it. And I started giving the roundup, that's it. And I'm trying not to scare the kids because their father is drowning.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it hit me, I am drowning. You know, like, you know how, because you always hear the story.
It hit me, he banged his head on the mic stand, he's out.
But listen. You always hear about these great swimmers that get fatigued. They get tired, right, Andy, and drown.
Oh, yeah.
From fatigue.
Sure.
You know, and I can't breathe because I've been, you know, I've just been drugged
and
by
that
a boat.
That jacket's not holding you up.
No, the jacket, and it's up over my head and like that. So then I panic. I have to admit, a panic hit me. Must get in the boat.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You know, and you know, you ever been 280 try to get in a boat out of 100 feet of water? It's not that easy. So I panic and I just start climbing in. I mean, the kids are crying. You're like, grab me. Look, at one point, I hurt.
Are you saying grab me?
Grab your daddy. You know what I mean? You know, and Sherry's. And
grab me.
And Sherry's got the baby and she can't help me. You know, Blake's pulling. We can't get you in, daddy. You know, I can't. You know, Brandy. Oh! You know, I can't. Somebody grab your daddy. You know, like that. So I've got my, look, at one point, my leg is up on the motor. And I'm hanging, pull your daddy in. My Callaway Garden, Cypress Garden moment. You know, I wanted to be up.
Oh,
I was going to drop one, slalom, and I've been reduced to headless. You know, I've got the life jacket on my head, coughing up gas. Clutching the side of the boat.
Oh, man.
I've got a vision of you having one foot in and the other hanging out.
No, and then I get
you're
in.
You're hollering, Bodine, grab a leg.
Yeah, Bodine, help me. You know, and then somebody pull your meal ticket in. You know, so then I get in there, and I finally get in. My hair's all messed up, and I can't breathe because of my... Like that, and all of a sudden, you know, you love the kids. Daddy, you almost got up. And I'm sitting there, and then that male pride hits you.
Oh, see, I got the same thing.
And Sherry says to me, Andy, she goes, did you panic?
Well, heck yeah.
Look, and I went, look, and I reached on her, you get that bottle of water? No, I was fine. I just
yeah.
I just didn't want to mess the boat up. I was trying to get in, let other people ski. So, look, and I wouldn't admit I panicked. Sherry said, "You panicked. Your face is pale." I said, "No, I didn't panic. I was fine. I mean, I could swim."
Yeah, you should have just gone with a board. You know?
Yeah, give me another help, Daddy.
Somebody help you, Daddy.
Daddy needs the inner tube next time.
Yeah, that's what I said. Somebody get the inner tube back. Yeah. Pull me around a little bit. We'll be back.
Rick and Bubba, Rick and Bubba.